In this bite, you will learn how to drive HR analytics value in 1 week. So, stay tuned. HR analytics promises tremendous value to organizations who leverage it for good. However, starting with analytics is often seen as a big hurdle. In this bite, you will learn 5 steps, one for each day of the week, so you can implement HR analytics in your organization incredibly fast. So, let's go through these 5 steps and then see how they can help you to deliver value through analytics. Step 1. What single overriding business purpose would motivate everyone in the business? Step 2. What are the business strategy's priorities? Owners, shouldn't we know these already? Step 3. What existing analytics are being done? Who looks at them and what do they think and do? Step 4. How much is being spent on internal and external people analytics? Step 5. What is the regular schedule over the next 12 months for reviewing the outputs and connecting to new priorities? Now, let's go over these one by one to see how they can deliver the most value. On Monday, have a single overriding purpose. The challenge of thinking through a single overriding purpose is a good one for any organization, as it gives direction to all other analytical questions. Several organizations have transformed themselves by using a shared reference point to coordinate change. Alcoa, a U.S. aluminum producer, for instance, saw successful transformation when a new CEO took office and focused all conversations on safety. As one aim that everyone could agree on, it helped the organization discuss the other things that were needed. Joint working, analyzing, tracking, learning from errors, simplification, and training. The result was a transformation in performance along with a significant improvement in safety. Similarly, when Atul Gawande sought to implement the World Health Organization's checklist for better health, he oriented hospitals around simple but significant goals, such as reducing the number of deaths. This was a clear target, and it motivated everyone to get behind this new ways of working. Next, Save Tuesday for strategic priorities. Even when the overall purpose is clear and aligned, how to achieve it is still uncertain. Not everyone has the same understanding of strategic targets. Should we prioritize sales of products or sales of services? Should we focus more on new customers or customer retention, new features or usability? There will be different answers from each person in the organization and from each executive until strategic priorities are explicitly established. Setting strategic priorities can be sorted out in 1 day, but if the head of HR analytics can have the conversation with the HR director or the HRD with the CEO for that matter, it helps to set the scene for all that follows. Should the executive team already be aligned on the priorities? Perhaps. But all too often, there are different views, so go as high as you can to get the best view that you can. The output should be a list of assumed strategic priorities for the business. That's Tuesday done. On Wednesday, analyze the existing analytics landscape. What existing people analytics initiatives are going on in the business? How often? Is it regular or ad hoc? Who looks at them? And the old classic question, if you were to stop creating your HR reports for a month or two, would anyone notice? What do your customers think of HR analysis that is being produced? What decisions are they changing because of what the reports say? On Wednesday, you should be able to populate a list of all the analytic initiatives and efforts happening in the organization. Who uses them? Whether they find them useful, and what they actually do with them. Your target should be to find the 3 least used reports and to stop them. On Thursday, you should consider how much is being spent in internal and external analytics. How much do you actually spend on all this analytical work? Of course, it's not only your internal team that carries out people analytics. Most large organizations see a rotating carousel of consultants coming in to offer insights. Now, can you estimate the money spent on these initiatives? If you don't know the spend, don't worry. Assume a day rate per consultant and make a rough estimate of how much is going where. What you want to aim for is to get a rough idea of where the organization is putting its time and money and the returns it gets for each analytics line or initiative. What is the regular schedule over the next 12 months for reviewing the outputs and connecting new priorities? Would it work for you and your boss to sit down once every 3 months to review what analytics initiatives are happening and how they connect to the strategic aims of the business? How about if you knew how many decisions were getting changed on the basis of analysis and how much it was costing you to produce? Are there any systems you could switch off because they are simply not needed anymore? Are there strategic questions that are important for the business that are not being addressed with analytical insight? Could you redirect your resources there? At the end of 1 week, you will have a much better idea of your strategic direction than you had at the start. Ideally, you will have reached out to your directors or managers and realign your team's work with their aims. You may also produce a populated template that will stand as a point-in-time report on your analytics, its cost, and its impact, as well as foundation for the adding even more value in the future. Now that you have completed these steps, you might want to just go ahead and implement what you've just learned. To make it even easier for you, we've made sure to include a one-week HR analytics impact template that you can access by following the download link in the description. If you're interested in more details concerning how to drive HR analytics value in 1 week, remember to check out the links in the description and make sure to stay up to date with our daily bites by subscribing to our channels. Also, if you like this video, make sure you like and share it, and I'll see you in our next daily bite.